Kia ora, I'm Miriam McCumwell. Lockdown and shutdown, that's where our economy is right now. This pandemic isn't just a health threat, it's a plague for finance, for business, and we are all preparing for how painful growing unemployment numbers will be. But this is just the beginning of uncharted waters. Rebecca Wright on what happens when you flick the switch on an entire economy.
The rhythm of these days has an unusual pace.
This is the biggest challenge we will face as a country in our lifetimes.
Life is desolate, quiet, surreally contained.
New Zealand is on a wartime footing. We will see many businesses fail. We will see many people lose jobs.
Jobs are already disappearing.
I burst into tears and my whole life just changed.
And I knew, okay, we need to make a plan here.
3 weeks now of this lockdown and I'm over it.
It's pretty simple. It's bleeding cash. It's, I really would like to get back to work.
So what shape will the shadow of this virus take on the country?
I get up at 6 in the morning. I'm at work by 7. I get home at 8. I get to sleep at midnight. I push repeat, around it goes.
Rob Fyfe's already learning the most important lesson about climbing out of this crisis.
You need to go harder than you think you need to go, and you need to go faster.
The former Air New Zealand CEO's moved to Wellington and is working for the government.
When the Prime Minister offered me the opportunity to come in and be a part of the solution, you know, I leapt at that opportunity.
And straight into sourcing personal protective equipment from China, which taught Fyfe there's no real playbook for what's required to stay ahead of this virus.
Such a new issue that we're dealing with. So, you know, we went and spent $20 million without even knowing whether that was enough, whether it's too much, whether that would last a month or last 6 months. But you have to get moving and you have to get mobilising.
That urgency will be crucial moving out of this crisis.
It's going to change the fabric of our societies and the way our businesses operate. And I think for many of us, that's dawning on us, right? And the enormity of that can be a little overwhelming.
Life is already changing dramatically for some.
I'm so grateful to be here today.
Now working the night shift at the supermarket, people whose jobs are impacted by the lockdown.
I worked doing your corporate events, you know, on the world stage. Obviously, you don't want to have 1,000 people in a room anymore. So it's almost like closing the loop. When I was a student, I worked in a supermarket. And, you know, here I am again. I can go to sleep at night knowing the rent's paid.
I knew it was going to affect my life in the sense that the airlines were all starting to sort of stop a lot of flight. Yeah, you couldn't really comprehend it until... I still kind of can't, right? I guess. It takes a bit of time for it all to sink in.
So what happens when you flick the switch on an entire economy?
How would you describe these days that we're having?
Well, this is a deep freeze for the economy. This is so unusual. It's essentially something out of a movie or a book.
Economist Shamubeel Eaqub on what we know so far.
Hospitality.
Hospitality is the industry that will face the biggest amount of pain.
Retail.
Parts of retail will do really well. I think people are going to go back to basics.
Agriculture.
There is so much fear of food running out in the world that I think our farmers are very, very well placed.
The film industry.
The film industry is going to do it really tough, but of course it's offset by a massive increase in demand for online things like Netflix.
Tourism.
Tourism is in a very, very deep hole. And, you know, the best case scenario is that it drops by 25%. The worst case is probably worse than 50%.
It's extraordinary, isn't it?
We're living in, I think, the most extraordinary time in many generations. It's a modern day plague.
There are dark clouds looming.
We will see many businesses fail. We will see many people lose jobs. People will experience poverty who have never experienced poverty before in their lifetimes.
Unemployment, it's going to be painful. What's your outlook for unemployment?
In a typical recession, we think about job losses in tens of thousands. In this recession, we should be thinking about it in hundreds of thousands.
Right now, the government's wage subsidy is a ray of hope for 1.4 million Kiwis, providing a lifeline for some of our biggest companies.
I think there's a lot of people in Air New Zealand that are hurting at the moment.
It cuts deeply for Fyfe.
I spent a chunk of my life investing my heart and soul, you know, into Air New Zealand, and for me, you know, it still feels a lot like family.
What do you see its future as?
Hopefully, if we can restart and grow a domestic network, but I would expect that international flying, at least in the next couple of years, is going to be very, very limited.
Unease is likely to last until a vaccine or treatment is developed, which could take 12 to 18 months.
We have to make sure we're putting our resources and support behind those businesses that have a future in the new world.
When did you find out that you weren't going to be going back to work?
The aviation industry was pretty much told that flying was going to reduce to 80 to 90%.
What was that moment like?
It was awful. I still actually can't believe that it's happened.
And why was it important to you to get a job?
Because I need to feel like I'm doing something.
It's important to your identity, to be coming to work.
Yeah. I've always had a job.
I was working as security and filming. Never thought I'd end up doing supermarkets. I'd say I'm quite lucky because I'm still able to, you know, provide for family. Keep thinking this could be the new normal, and then I'm over it. I kind of want to go back to my normal life.
Reality is also biting for small business owners like Ross Nolan.
The state of my business at the moment is pretty simple. It's bleeding cash. We're supporting five families.
He's topping up the government wage subsidy for his employees.
I'm spending my life savings to pay my guys so that I'll have a business to operate when we go back to normal.
He can survive lockdown, but needs to know what happens next.
4 weeks is no problem. 8 weeks is a bit uncomfortable. 16 weeks would be catastrophic.
What would help you?
More information. It's impossible to plan.
Small and medium businesses are literally the nervous system of the economy. Without them, everything shuts down.
We won't truly know the impact of this virus until unemployment numbers catch up.
The clarity of communication so far that we've seen around the health side is what we need to see on the economic side. We really need an Ashley Bloomfield of economics.
What is the scale of the response that has to come?
No holds barred. Make sure that we preserve as many jobs, as many businesses as possible. And when it fails, make sure the welfare safety net is as strong and as tight as possible so we catch the people.
How are we going to pay for all of this?
Look, this pandemic is probably going to cost us well upwards of $50 billion. And we're going to have to repay it somehow. I think there are two ways that we could repay it. One is we charge taxes on wealth and future generations, or the Reserve Bank could print money, and that would mean that people who have wealth now would be devalued.
I can imagine a lot of people yelling at their TV screens right now.
Yeah, and look, there are no good choices because the cost of doing this is very large. The cost of not doing it is larger.
And as the economy gets moving again, there will be bright spots.
We need a new economy. You know, there are things that we will have to invest in to replace the things we've lost.
To invest in technology, to upgrade our infrastructure, to really invest in greening our economy.
And do you think that that is now on the table?
That's the opportunity that's in front of us. And whether we take it or not is up to our political leaders and what we do as a society.
And what do you see for in the future for you?
Well, that's an interesting question. Obviously, we just have to, you know, move ahead.
In my future, I'm still flying. And that's all I'm thinking. It's just going to be a very strange world for quite a long time.
What do you think our future looks like?
I'm an optimist. We'll come out the other side of this. It will be different. We'll have to make some tough decisions, but, you know, I'm proud to be a New Zealander.
And the alternative is what much of the rest of the world is going through right now.
It's going to be a very good natural experiment to see what was the right answer. And we won't know until time passes. But from a human perspective, I do not want my government to put the people of New Zealand at risk. The economy doesn't matter.